No! Farther! More than that! Go all the way back!
Okay.
Wait. Don't tell me.
Clover's 4 and Ace is 1. Added to the ninth man's 9, 4 plus 1 plus 9 is 14, and the digital root of, in other words...
Thank God you were all so cooperative. Now I can get out of this nightmare. Good! I don't need you anymore! Wait! Here! She's all yours!
Okay, have a good one, guys.
I'm going off ahead now. Well then, goodbye!
Clover, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Damn it! That bastard! Open, damn it! Shit! It won't budge.
Do you hear something?
Like, what?
Like, some sort of beeping.
You're right. I can hear it too.
What is it?
Shit! Why isn't it stopping? God damn it! You lied!
Lied?
This wasn't supposed to happen! This is wrong! This is wrong!
What is happening in there?
Open the door, please! I'm begging you! Help me! Please get me out of here! Get me out of here!
Ugh, God damn it! Why? Why won't it work? Engaged? Is it because it's occupied?
Oh my God, oh my God! There's no time left! Listen, I was lied to! He lied to me! He put me in here! It was him! He killed me! It was him!
A beep? Did that thing just make that sound?
The display changed from engaged to vacant.
Let's see if we can open it.
Okay.
Well, it registered my bracelet number. But it won't open with one person. We need at least two more people.
Santa and, June, you think you could give me a hand here?
Hmm.
5 plus 3 plus the digital root, this should do it. Now we just need to pull the lever on the side.
You guys ready? I'm gonna open it.
Oh my God!
Good God! Whoa, that's pretty bad.
He blew up.
June, are you okay? What the hell? Where'd this fever come from? All right, okay, let's just rest for a minute, okay? You think you can walk? Here we go. How are you feeling? Are you all right?
Why? Why did this happen? Why did this happen?
Do any of you know what the fuck is going on here? Who's Zero? What's this Nonary game? Come on! Anybody? Anything? What the hell is going on?
It's 10 o'clock then. That means it's been an hour since Zero's little announcement.
Fuck! I've had enough of this crap! How long are we gonna pussyfoot around like this? We've only got 8 hours until this time limit Zero is going on about is up. Let's get going already. Go! Go!
No, I refuse. I'm not gonna end up like him.
Him? You mean the ninth man?
Of course. Who else?
Blood. Blood and pieces of flesh. That's no way for a person to die.
I think he just screwed up. He probably set off some sort of trap, and that killed him. I'm not gonna screw up like that. I'm getting out of here alive! What's so goddamn funny?
Oh, my apologies. You were just, so very confident. I couldn't help myself.
What the fuck?
I think you've mistaken the situation.
Huh?
The ninth man's death. It had nothing to do with the trap. Or at least, not the sort of trap you imagine it did.
Then?
He broke one of Zero's rules. That was why he died. Quite simple if you think about it.
Huh?
You still don't... All right. How about you take a moment and think back to what Zero said? Specifically, what did he say about the number of people?
He said only 3 to 5 people can pass through one numbered door.
And after that? You've forgotten the relevant part. What did Zero say?
All those who enter must leave, and all who enter must contribute, right? I think it was something like that. Whatever it was, it means that groups of less than 3 or more than 5 can't go through.
That is correct. A gold star for you, Junpei. The ninth man, however, broke that rule. He tried to pass through a numbered door by himself. That was why he was executed.
And Zero's watching us from somewhere, making sure we don't break any rules.
Oh, I'm not so sure of that.
Why not?
Because this execution system is entirely automatic. You didn't notice? There's no need for him to monitor us.
What do you mean?
Very well. I see it must be me who tells you. I've waited long enough, I suppose. I had hoped Zero might spare me the trouble, but that seems increasingly unlikely.
Do you know something?
Well, I know a great many things, but yes.
What is it you know?
Here.
A card? What does it say?
See for yourself.
Come on now, what's the point of giving me this?
Give me that. Huh? The hell is this?
I see.
This is Braille. Sorry, guys, I can't read this. Here, have it back.
Okay, that was fun. What's so important about that card?
I found it in my pocket. I can only assume it is a message from Zero.
From Zero?
A message?
What does it say?
Calm down now. No need to panic. You don't need to force me. I'll read it. Bracelet number 2. Since you are not blessed with sight, I shall bless you and only you with information. I shall tell you of the function of the red, of the dead, and of the bracelet.
The red is the recognition device. It will verify your number. Beside every numbered door, you will find a red. The dead is the deactivation device. It does exactly what it says. Once you have passed through the numbered door, you must use the dead to stop the detonator in your bracelet. But perhaps you are wondering, what does this detonator detonate? I am afraid this might be something of a surprise. I have placed a small bomb inside of you and the people whom you are about to meet. You swallowed it while you were unconscious. I have no doubt, by the time you read this note, the bomb will have passed your stomach and found its way to your small intestine. In other words, you will be unable to regurgitate it. I suggest you do not try. As I mentioned before, the bracelet on your left hand contains a detonator. Think of it as a remote fuse, or timer, for the bomb in your body. There is only one condition to cause it to detonate. That condition is that you enter a numbered door. Once you have done so, the timer will activate, no matter who you may be. You will have 81 seconds. If, at that time, the detonator has not been deactivated, it will send a signal to the bomb nearby, and Sputnik 2 explode. In order to deactivate the detonator, every person who verified their number at the red must also verify their numbers at the dead. Once all numbers have been verified but dead, you need only pull the lever at its side, and the countdown will cease. Anyone who does not verify their number at the red will find themselves unable to verify their number at the dead. That is to say, if you can pass through a numbered door without first verifying your number at the red, in 81 seconds, you will be dead. You must also keep in mind that the numbered doors will close automatically after 9 seconds have passed. So long as the door is open, the dead will not function. You will do well to remember this. Lastly, let's discuss how to remove the bracelets. There are only 2 ways to do so. 1. You escape from this ship. 2. Your heart rate reaches 0. In other words, once the bracelet is taken outside the confines of the ship, or it acts like Lara's heartbeat has fallen to 0, it will shut down automatically. There is no other way to remove your bracelet. If you attempt to force it off or disable the detonator, the bomb within you will immediately explode.
This is all the information which I can impart to you. How you choose to use it is for you to decide. If used wisely, you can eliminate those who might be a danger to you. For a time, you would be able to control your fate. I wish you the best of luck.
So it's saying, only those who verify their numbers at the red can pass through the numbered doors. Teams can't add or
the red's dead.
Shit! A fucking bomb!
There's a bomb inside me. Oh, what made Zero think creating this horror show of a game was a good idea?
All right, I'm gonna ask one more time. Do any of you know anything about Zero? Actually, I saw him. I didn't see his face, though. Son of a bitch was wearing some kind of gas mask. What the hell? Come on, guys, give me something. You know, like, surprise or something.
I saw that, too.
I did as well.
Me, too. I didn't see inside the mask, though. That mask, it was really scary.
Huh?
Oh, so all of our abductions were the same. We were taken from home at midnight. The person claiming to be Zero had a mask on. There was white smoke, and then each of us passed out. We woke up to find ourselves on D-Deck, in a room with a 3-level bunk bed.
How about you, Seven? Did the same happen to you?
Oh, me? Yeah, well, mine was just like the rest of yours.
Okay, that's good enough for now. So, I have a question. Snake and Clover, you were both kidnapped from the same room, and you woke up together. So, what's the deal with the two of you anyway?
We're siblings.
Siblings?
Yes. Snake is my older brother, obviously. That means I'm his little sister. That really so hard to understand?
She is correct, of course. Are you, surprised?
Well, yeah, but...
Why? There are other people here with connections to one another. Those two, for instance.
Oh, you mean between Jumpy and me?
Ah, yes. You did say you were childhood friends, didn't you?
Wait, you went to school together?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Hey, you think maybe we could figure out who Zero is this way?
Yeah, you're right. You connect the dots between the victims and that leads you to the perp. Textbook stuff.
Junpei. June. Does any of this ring a bell?
Ring a bell.
Ring a bell?
Well, perhaps you went to school with the son of a multimillionaire.
A millionaire?
Son?
Well, someone bought this boat and set up all of this. Whoever Zero is, they must be incredibly rich.
Well, we can't be sure of that. To me, this seems as though it's the work of an organization, not an individual. Most likely, Zero is simply the representative of a larger group.
What sort of organization?
It could be a number of things. An army, perhaps, or a research group. Perhaps this is all some sort of psychological experiment.
If it is, then it's a pretty fucked up experiment. I mean, come on! A guy's dead! I don't know who the hell this Zero asshole is, but I know for sure he's gotta be pretty fucked up in the head to do all this. If this was all one guy, then he's got some serious issues.
I thought we were finished with that topic.
But then what should we do?
We should talk it through.
Oh my god, enough! All we're doing is talking! Talking won't solve anything! It can't help us find our way out of here! You really sure you want to just sit around? We've only got 7.5 hours left. We already wasted 1.5 hours of our 9 hours.
You're right.
Very well then. There's only one way for us to proceed.
Sure not gonna be fun running around knowing we gotta jump when Zero says jump.
Well, it's stupid to just sit around here doing nothing.
Thanks to Snake's card, at least we have some idea of how this all works.
Correct. And so long as we all follow the rules, we should, we will most likely be all right.
But...
But what?
Who's going to go in which door?
Oh yeah, that's right. We can't have any more than... All 8 of us can't go in the same...
Then it would seem we...
Wait! I'm telling you now, there is no way in hell that I'm going into door 5.
Come on now, don't be selfish.
Call me whatever the hell you want. I'm not going in there. If I'm going to have to walk through all that blood, then I'd rather stay here.
And we were doing so well.
Sorry, but I ain't going in there either. Someone else can go into door 5.
Oh, Santa, not you too.
Hey man, I just bought these shoes. If you think I'm getting some creepy dude's blood all over him, you got another thing coming.
What the hell, man? Weren't you the one who kept saying we should get going?
Yeah. So, doesn't mean I wanted to go into door 5.
Oh, God.
Fine, I'll go into door 5. I can't go in there alone, though. Anyone else willing to come with me?
I'll go.
What?
Don't worry. You'll be fine. We may part now. But I'm certain we'll meet again later.
How do you know that?
Because I do.
That's not an answer! If you're going, I'm going too. I'm going into door 5.
What am I going to do with you?
There's nothing you have to do. If I join you, the problem is solved, correct? 7 is 7, and Snake is 2. And if you add Clover's 4 and my 1, the digital root will be 5.
7 plus 2 plus the digital root of...
Works perfectly! The 4 of us can go into door 5!
Wait. What about the other 4? What's their digital route gonna be?
Lotus, Santa, our bracelet, 836. (laughs) 8 plus 3 plus 6, the digital route of...
It's 4. Add up our 4 bracelet numbers and the digital route is 4.
Then we can go into door 4.
Yeah. Huh. That worked out well.
So the team assignments will be like this. 7, Snake, Clover, and Ace, they would go through door 5. Lotus, Santa, June, and me will go through door 4.
Are these really the teams I want? Beyond door 5 is what remains of the Ninth Man. I never want to see that thing again, but something's telling me that it'd be a good idea to examine the corpse. Even just a little closer. Of course, if I went through door 5, I wouldn't be going with Lotus and Santa. I could bring June with me through door 5, but that means she'd have to see the body in there. I don't want to put her through that. Should I stay silent and go through door 4? Or should I stop them and insist on door 5?
All right then,
It seems we've reached a conclusion. I'm going through door 5.
We're over there too, right, Snake?
The door's not going anywhere. Slow down.
Which door?
Hey, wait. I want to go through door 5 too.
What? What are you saying, Jumpy? If you're going through that door, then I'm going with you.
No, you can't. I can't take you with me.
Why?
Well, you know what's in there, don't you? Are you sure you want to see that?
Well...
Please, let me go into door 5.
Man, now we're right back where we started, you know that?
Junpei's bracelet is number 5, right? If we are going to add Junpei, then we must subtract 5 from the rest of us. Ace, please, take good care of Clover.
Oh, all right. That's fine.
Don't go away!
You need to listen to me, Clover. Go to door 4 with the others.
No!
Don't be so selfish.
Why?
You'll be fine. Just relax.
What did he tell her?
Okay, I understand.
Let's make sure we've got this straight. Those going to door 5 are me, 7, and Snake. 7 plus 2 plus... and the digital... And those going to door 4, Lotus, 8, and the digit... We're okay with this.
No problems here.
Yes. Let's do it.
All right, then. The lever's all that's left.
Okay.
All right, then. Let's go.
Okay. Please be careful.
We will. And it's open. Oh.
That's messed up.
That was the ninth man. Oh.
How can you...
Well, do you intend to kill me? I assume you haven't forgotten the door only remains open for 9 seconds, have you?
Sorry.
Let's go!
Damn it! The countdown started!
Shit! The door!
There's no turning back now. And if we don't manage to find the deactivation device...
Hey, where is the dead?
How the hell should I know?
Stay calm. Look around you.
Okay, I get it. Ah! Found it! Right here! Well, it looks like it stopped.
Goddamn thing's gonna give me a heart attack.
Jumpy, are you all right? Are you guys okay?
Yeah, we're fine. The detonators have been deactivated.
All right, we're moving on. Be careful, okay?
Okay.
Sure thing.
And they're gone. Now, doesn't look like we can go any further this way.
Maybe this wall can be moved. Or not. It's not budging.
Hey, there's a door over there.
A first-class cabin, huh?
Well, it seems like it.
Let's have a look then, shall we? All right then, let's go.
Yeah.
Oh. I don't want to look, but... Oh, it's so horrible. He'd been wearing these. The bracelet's off. Oh wait, Zero did say...
Lastly, there are not two.
The bracelet comes off when you're dead. Oh, but what the hell's the point of getting it off when you end up like this? Oh, just imagining how it must have happened. This was a human. Oh, God. I feel like I'm gonna puke. Oh, I gotta get out of here. Where did they... Through here?
Ooh.
What's up?
Check this out. We found this thing here on the door.
The red light's on. Does that mean it's locked?
So I would assume.
Is there any other way out?
We looked around a little. Other than this door, we didn't find anything.
So you're telling me that unless we can open this door?
Yes. We won't be going anywhere.
This looks like a bedroom.
Then the other room is probably a living room. Or the closest you can get to one on a ship.
All right, let's find a way to open this door. Come on, guys!
What's wrong? You got weird all of a sudden.
I heard something strange.
Something strange?
Ah, well, never mind. It doesn't seem to be anything suspicious. I don't wish to toot my own horn, but my auditory senses are considerably more advanced than those of most humans. I notice even the slightest of noises.
Right. Are you gonna tell me you can hear a needle drop from a mile away?
No. Such a thing would be impossible. However, by listening to the sound of footsteps and breathing, as well as sound echoing off the environment, I can locate most objects.
Oh yeah, that's right. When Clover fell on the big staircase a little while ago, you were at her side immediately. So that was...
Yes, I could hear it happening. In fact, I can run quite fast. Certainly as fast as you. And should someone attempt to start a fight with me, I am quite confident that I could defeat them.
Oh, really?
You don't believe me, do you? Care to give it a try? I must warn you, you'll no doubt regret it. Well, I suppose that's enough playing around. Let's resume our search, shall we?
Hey, Seven. What the hell was that? Are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine. I just felt a little dizzy, that's all. What the hell is wrong with me? First memory loss, now I'm getting dizzy for no reason.
Memory?
Oh, yeah. I guess I didn't tell you, huh? I told the rest of them before we ran into you on the stairs. I told them I couldn't remember a damn thing from before I woke up. Didn't realize I hadn't told you.
Whoa, wait a minute. You're talking about amnesia, right?
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, why are you an amnesiac? What happened to you?
If I knew that, I wouldn't really be one, would I?
Oh, yeah, I guess that's true. Are you telling the truth?
Huh?
Well, you look pretty calm for somebody who doesn't remember anything. If you've really got amnesia, shouldn't you be, like, upset or confused or something?
Well, sure. I was pretty confused when I woke up down on D-Deck, but that was a while ago. I've had some time to get used to it. After a while, I figured it wasn't worth the trouble of worrying about it. After all, why worry about something I can't change? Well, people usually don't stay amnesiacs forever. I figure it'll work itself out eventually.
But that's it?
That's it. Alright, that's enough talking for now. Let's get back to work.
How are you fine with something like that?
Oh.
another hallway? Hmm?
That should do it.
What's he up to?
I was just putting one of those plates in there. It ought to keep the door from locking again. Now we can come back here anytime we want, right?
Ah, why would you want to come back here?
I might like to play a little piano.
Piano?
Come on, let's get moving. We aren't out of this yet.
Well then?
Can't say I could ever imagine Seven playing the piano. He couldn't use the piano in there anyway. The keyboard's a mess. But why would he want to leave the door unlocked then? I have no clue.
Hey, wait for me!
Whoa, a metal grate?